beautiful life came to a sudden end. He died as he lived, everyone's friend. He was always hardworking, good-hearted, and kind. What a legacy he leaves behind. He left us suddenly, his thoughts unknown, but he left us memories we're proud to own. Treasure him, God, in your garden of rest, for in our world, he was one of the best. Hello, my name is Candice Anderson, owner of Reflections Funeral Services and the officiant for today's service. I met Reg and Linda early last year when his mother-in-law passed away and I was in care of her arrangements, and I instantly liked them. Although it was always a somber time, losing a loved one, it was easy to connect with the Everest family. I loved how straightforward and good-natured everyone was. And you could tell that family came first. Even with every quip of humor or poke in the ribs, you knew it came from a place of love. And now, meeting with Linda again, and also his children to plan his service, it's evident that a legacy lives on in them. The laughs, the care, and the unity is continuing on with the values that he instilled. There was a way about Reg that you knew you could be honest with him, have a bit of fun teasing one another, and always a good laugh or two by the end of the conversation. He had straightforward opinions and ensured that he was doing right by others. He was a genuine individual who gave his time wholeheartedly to his wife, children, grandchildren, friends, and strangers alike. I truly consider it an honor to be speaking on his family's behalf today. And I also would like to express on their behalf their gratitude to the community of individuals who show their support. The phone calls, visits, food, cards, condolences, prayed prayers, and presents here today are more than appreciated in this challenging time. I'll ask us to bow our heads in prayer. Heavenly Father, please bless Reg's family and friends in whatever it is that you know what they may be needing in this day. May their lives be filled by your peace, prosperity, and power as they seek to have a closer relationship with you. Amen. I will welcome forward Dennis and Helen to provide us with a musical tribute, Gone Home.
All of the friends that I loved yesterday, they have gone home, they have gone home.
The songbirds that sing in the dales in your say,
they have gone home, they have gone home.
They've joined the heavenly home.
They're walking the streets of pure gold.
They left one by one as their work here was done.
They have gone home,
gone home.
They have gone home.
Life here is lonely since they've gone before. Gone home,
have gone home,
gone home.
They have gone home.
The old weeping willow that stands by the door sadly says,
they have gone home,
gone home.
They have gone home.
They've joined the heavenly fold. They're walking the streets of pure gold. They left one by one as their work here was done.
They have gone home.
Gone home.
They have
this, and Reg, this was for you.
From the words of Matthew 5:4, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Today will be a mix of emotions as we shed tears in our pain, turn to one another for comfort, laugh in our memories, and celebrate the man that was Reg. I'm so thankful that we're able to return to the proper funeral format, especially in our small towns, where your neighbors become family and your roots are established amongst the community. A time of grieving is experienced in many different ways, but a funeral is an important part of this process. Not only are we honoring Reg today, but we're acknowledging the relationships that he had established and the transition we will all feel in his loss. Today's service will allow for healing as we share our memories and allow for a sense of peace as we recognize the impact that both his life and death has had on us. But when we go to leave today, also realize that the funeral marks the beginning of the transition through grief, and that the support will be needed going forward from this moment. Reg had a big personality, and his absence will be felt. He was consistently busy, whether it was working on a project of some sort, attending the grandkids' sporting events, camping or traveling, or devising his next evil plot to terrorize or scare someone. Even his children had mentioned how they worried about how they would keep track of him in future years once old age settled in. He could work circles around all the young guys and always believed in being a hard worker. Anytime someone mentioned about the stench of the cows, you tell them they better not complain because that's the smell of money. He had a great sense of humor, and he even had his happy little jig that he would do when he was about to razz one of his grandchildren with some kind of half-truth or wild goose chase. With each introduction of a new baby into the family, he anxiously awaited the day he could give them a good fright. His nephews Kirby and Corey had a good laugh for years about the time they talked bitterly about their broken snowblower. So Reg pointed out to the snow shovel with the hanging electrical cord and claimed that could be their replacement. And I hear that there's apparently a very special way to stomp and wave and dance to start a fire. His good nature ran over into generosity as well. I had those from the auction market contact me about how Reg would make sure that if someone could pay for a meal, no matter the circumstance, he'd take care of it. And there wasn't another occasion where another family was going through hardships in their times of grief, and he insisted on not receiving any payment for his own services. He didn't pat himself on the back for these actions. He did so from a genuine place. We'll continue these memories with the eulogy from Clarence and Dennis.
We'd like to thank Linda and family for having us read this eulogy written by the family. Reginald Everest, known as Reg, was born September 26, 1948, in Regina, Saskatchewan. His parents moved numerous times before settling on the farm near Kitsgully. Reg grew up with brother Lindsay and sister Shirley. He lost his brother Stanley at a young age. Reg's dad taught him many skills of farming, carpentry, fishing, and camping, but the best skill was storytelling. Using his carpentry skills, one of his first jobs was building a school in Lloydminster. While cruising one night in Lloyd, Reg met Linda at A&W. Where she was working at the time. They were married on August 15, 1970 in Kitsgully. From this union, three children were born, Janice, Larry, and Kelly. After settling in Vermilion, Reg worked for a couple companies before he found employment with Brothers Transport around 1971. I met Reg and Linda when I started working for George Brothers in the spring of 1973. Reg and I became lifelong friends, and we had lots of fun together. Later, when I started farming, and there was cattle to be shipped, you could be sure Reg was in one of the trucks. He agreed to with a big grin with a whip in his hand. When I bought feeders, Reg would be the one to haul them out. Usually at night after he had finished his other loads for that day. When the feeders were unloaded, we would go up to the house and have a good visit with coffee and stuff.
That's true, old stuff. Anyway, I met Reg back in the late 60s. We were at a dance one night southeast of Kitscotty, and Reg come in there, half snockered or whatever, and he was laughing. He got about 2 miles from dancing, and his little Volkswagen didn't quite make the turn, so he was laying on his side. He said, "That's all right, we'll get it some other day," and he enjoyed the evening. That's where Reg was, eh? But anyway, I joined the Brothers team in 1976 and worked with Reg hauling cattle. This brings to mind the time that Reg took a van trailer down to Calgary for a load of Coca-Cola because they needed some pop back at the plant here. So he backed into the dock, got out, took out his stock whip, walked back to the end of the trailer and realized he wasn't loading cattle at all. But we never let him forget that. I mean, that was something I wouldn't let him forget. And in 1979, Reg bought the George Brothers Livestock Trucking. And Everest Trucking became a new adventure for him. While Reg was trucking, Linda did the grunt work. Together, their business flourished. George and Lil were great mentors and huge supporters over the years. When Reg was home, he made time for family and camping and holiday trips. He made sure the kids seen new roads and new places. And I remember we'd come back from trucking somewhere and Reg would park in the shop and Reg said, "Oh, come on over to the house, we'll have some lunch." And so I ate there lots of times with them guys and with Linda and Reg and the kids. And yeah, we had some good times. And the kids remember his choice of unusual music, especially on Sunday evenings. That's when on camera hose, it didn't take long for him to have the kids in the truck with him and looked around forward to teaching the boys to drive.
When Reg married Linda, he gained a wonderful father and mother-in-law, as well as a set of outlaws.
You say outlaws? Did you say that? I think you're right.
Linda loved very much. When helping move Roy and Irene from Edgerton to Paradise Valley, Reg wanted to tease his mother-in-law. Outside of PV, Reg pulled over and tied a little red wagon behind his truck. He pulled it into a town and told Irene that he pulled it all the way from Edgerton. There were many family gatherings and camping trips. Many hours were spent on the lake learning to ski, and then he passed on his knowledge. One trip to Mirio Lake, Reg was tired from trucking, and a drink or two later, he fell asleep in the lawn chair. When the ladies went to the washroom, a skunk decided to visit the campsite. The boys ran out of the campsite, leaving Reg asleep with the skunk. Family and friends remember all the fun and laughter. Reg was always there to help anyone get parked with a big smile and a cold beer. He was known for making breakfast on the barbecue with a beer in his hand. If Reg couldn't be found for a while, you knew he was off helping fellow campers. He always felt strangers were just friends that you hadn't met yet. Reg's family was increased with the addition of a son-in-law, Roland, and two daughter-in-laws, Amy and Leslie, becoming a grandpa to Blair, Trina, Lucas, and Alana, brought more love and fun by tormenting them and telling them half-truths. Reg and Linda took numerous trips with the ground children, cherishing every minute he was always there for them. Later in life, he was pleasantly surprised to learn that he had an older brother and sister. He welcomed John and Vicky with open arms and gained more family members.
You know, Reg had a fantastic mind for numbers. He could calculate things faster in his head than most people could do on the calculator. Reg put in a lot of hard work and sweat shoveling cow manure to make Everest Trucking a success. He worked with royal staff and customers. Reg was really proud to truck with his sons and grandsons, making it three generations of truckers. He had a goal to drive for 50 years, which he accomplished and surpassed. He was always the first to the shop and had most of the projects half done before anyone else showed up. He would go to the shop or their campground behind the shop as soon as he'd seen someone pull up in, just in case they needed help or someone he could BS with, a session that usually included an instant coffee or cold beer. Over the years of trucking, Reg has accumulated many lifelong friends. Reg and Linda took their trips with family and friends. Every trip was fun and a good time for everyone.
After Larry took over the reins of the trucking company, they were able to take some time for themselves. After spending Christmas with the family, the RV was packed and they headed south to Arizona. Down south, even though he didn't have his shop nearby, he was still fixing and tinkering on things for himself or others. He became a shopping dude, searching for camper mats, chairs, sofa, solar panels, and other camping items for the kids. The days were filled with golfing, drinking, box wine, exploring new roads, visiting and sitting around the campfire. Their circle of friends expanded and expanded. Reg loved it when family would join them down south and could show them around. This often included margaritas in Mexico. The grandkids remember an instance when he traded his Everest trucking hat for a necklace for Linda. The Mexicans loved the Toro on the hat and Reg loved bartering until he got his way. He was always looking forward to going south again when the border opened up. Reg will be remembered for his laugh, shenanigans, patience, knowledge, and benevolence. He was loved and will be sadly missed.
Let us take a moment to reflect on these special times that we had with Reg as we listen to Brothers of the Highway.
Diamonds on the windshield, his heaven starts to cry. And in his rearview mirror, his angel waves goodbye. She knows he's gonna go. She knows he's one of them. Brothers of the highway, children of the wind. That Detroit diesel fired ship goes blowing out again. Sailing toward the setting sun, freedom's their best friend. Brothers of the highway, children of the wind. Oh, bring it on in there.
We'll put the pedal to the metal, try it out or run the rank. Another shot of truck stop coffee as I run in through his veins. This world turns on 18 wheels, thank God we can depend
on brothers of the highway, children of the wind. That Detroit diesel fire ship goes blowing out again. Sailing towards the setting sun, freedom's their best friend. Brothers of the highway, children of the wind. Carolina, west to Denver, Baton Rouge, east to Pittsburgh, port to south to San Diego. Sail on, Tallahassee. Troy diesel fired ship goes blowing out again. Sailing toward the setting sun, freedom's their best friend. Brothers of the highway, children of the wind.
Brothers of the highway,
children of the wind. That Detroit diesel fire ship goes blowing out again. Sailing toward the setting sun, freedom's their best friend. Brothers of the highway.
Ecclesiastes 3, verses 1 through 8. There's a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heavens. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. Time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to search and a time to give up. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. This passage of scripture portrays life as a roller coaster of events and emotions. Many of the trials experienced are unforeseeable, but God does not change. He does not leave us. Therefore, throughout each of these seasons, our one steady constant is the love of God. Each person has been created with their own path and may find themselves in specific scenarios for a time of everything, more so than others. But it can also be found that time has the ability to be our wisest teacher. The reading from Ecclesiastes orders that time by saying, there's a time for everything and a season for every activity under heaven. Time allows us to experience much of what life has to offer. Wonder, hope, suffering, love, work, play, loss, companionship, grief, accomplishment, disappointment, healing, and so many other things. Yet, time does not make the rules for how we use it. Some people can't and won't get enough time in this life to do all that we think should be intended for them, whereas others have more time than they know what to do with. Time, though suddenly cut short, had been granted to Reg, and he used it wisely. He was dedicated to his management of Everest Trucking. He built relationships with his customers, workers, family, and neighbors. His hands were busy with projects around the family home and operating his business. In between, he found the time to relax and enjoy life, whether it was spending time with loved ones or traveling the countryside or making up a story about some bruise on his face from an overindulged beverage or two. The seasons of time allow Reg the gift of his beloved wife, Linda, in creating their family, and enjoying life's trials of raising them, and being a part of their families as they wed and began extending their own families with the additions of grandchildren. Hid the joy and witnessing their life milestones as well. There is always time for making special memories, betting on the Chucks, and holiday adventures. But we know that time isn't everything. Time comes with consequences. Things break down, bodies slow, friends and loved ones die. And though he wouldn't complain about it, Reg felt this side of time as well. He took these pains with dignity and stride. Reg's life was shorter than we had hoped that it would be, but it was meticulously crafted with his own hand and filled with many, many happy moments spent doing what he loved.
I came from a town that was so small, you look both ways, you could see it all. All I wanted was some way out. Every evening I'd slip into town and stand around by the caution light and watch the big trucks rolling by. To me it was a beautiful sight, big wheels in the moonlight. I had a case of wanderlust. I'd lie awake with the windows up, out on Highway 59, I could hear something go be so my mind. Just those big old wheels.